sisters, I will proudly take a stand. When liberty's in jeopardy, I will always do what's right. I'm out here on the front lines, sleep in peace tonight. American soldier, I'm an American soldier.
And now, let us turn our attention to the Patriot Way Project. This project started many months ago, and like all projects start, it started with an idea. Today, you will learn about how that initial idea became a reality. And here to tell that story is one of the co-chairmen of the Patriot Way Project, Mr. Danny Dossman.
Thank you. This is a time that I've looked forward to for quite a while. Many of you have heard me talk about it. You know how I feel about it. But I have anticipated this day for quite a while. When I turned the corner off of Main Street, coming this way this morning, with all of the flags, I was just overwhelmed with a feeling of pride and patriotism, because I live in Belton, Texas. And Belton, Texas, to me, has always been Belton, America. We have our 4th of July parade, which is second to none in our hearts. And we finally have a visible symbol of our gratitude to the many veterans that have served our country. You see before you about 500 names of individuals who at one time or another gave great personal sacrifice to serve their country. I'm happy to see that many of those folks are here with us today, or their families. To all those brave and courageous people, I want to say a personal thank you for what you have done for our country and for our city and county. This project, which honors that service and that sacrifice, began with a simple conversation. I was asked what I thought about possibly putting bricks with names on them along Central Avenue. This was at the time when the city was considering its revitalization of Central, which is beautiful, Mayor, thank you. And I could think of no better group to honor in that way than the veterans who have served the country. So from that simple conversation, we now have Patriot Way, a way that will invite people into our community, but will also tell them a lot about our community. From the moment they come off the interstate, they will know how we feel about our country. They'll know how we feel about our veterans and those that have served our country. This is only the first phase of Patriot Way, though, and each year we hope to gather here and dedicate more bricks that will go in the street with more names of more people to be honored. Also, and if you haven't been over here, you'll see there's a little storyboard. We hope that we will have several of those along Patriot Way that will tell the stories of the men and women's names that are here in these bricks. You can help us with that by submitting stories to the chamber. They can be brief little comments about an individual, or they can be a long story about a wonderful service to our country. We will look at those things and select a few of them and develop these storyboards into sort of a walking tour as you go up and down the street. You will be able to buy those here at the chamber. The bricks are online, so there's an application on there at any time. We honor the folks whose names are here. Many of those gave a ultimate sacrifice. And to them, we again say thank you. This is truly a wonderful addition to our city. It's one that I'm very proud of. This morning, as I was standing here watching people look at their names, find their names, I noticed what appeared to be a grandmother, maybe her child, and then grandchildren. And she was showing them the brick. And more than likely, it was for the grandfather. And I couldn't help but think that's the whole purpose of this, is to show future generations and remember you folks to future generations and what you did for our country that allows us to be here and be free and enjoy the things that we do in our country today. Also, I'm pleased with the way everything turned out. I stood here this morning wondering what it's going to look like on the 4th of July when we have all the folks along the street and have a 4th of July parade go down this street with all the flags. That'll be another time that many people will be coming to town, sort of a reunion many times, families come back, and that will give them the opportunity to find the bricks of their loved one and remember the stories of them. I also want to say thank you and give a personal thank you to Stephanie O'Banion and the staff of the chamber. I had the good fortune to walk around and talk about this and kind of sell it, if you will, although it wasn't a hard sell. But it was Stephanie and her crew that did all the work. And so I think they deserve a round of applause. I also want to thank Michael Street, who was my co-chair. He was here somewhere. Michael, where are you? He was kind of the man in the back that did a lot of the work for me also. So I want to say thank you. But I do want to take a moment to say thank you to the veterans who served our country and allow us to have the life that we do. In a few moments, we'll cut a ribbon and dedicate this. I hope that each year we're able to gather here and honor new bricks with new names on them. And I'll use a little sale here for you, if you still have someone whose name needs to be here, you can contact the chamber. We want to do this every year. So thank you, and thank all those who have helped make this possible. Thank you.
Thank you, Danny. Great job. And none of this actually would have been possible without the collaboration and the approval, really, from the City of Belton as they were planning their redo of the street here and to allow the chamber to be part of it in this special way. So here to bring you words from that behalf is the Mayor, Jim Covington.
Thank you, Jay. What a great day for the City of Belton. And for our country and for our veterans. This this beautiful project, as Jay said, is a part of an overall larger project of enhancing the gateways into Belton, of which Central Avenue is the first. If you look at other public projects that are going on in Belton, it's almost mind-boggling from Central Avenue out to the Avenue D reconstruction to accommodate the construction of the new middle school in that area, the extension of Commerce Drive that will connect Sparta Road to FM 439. There is a plan, I'm sure many of you have heard, for the new 9th Avenue Bridge going across Nolan Creek that will make ingress and egress to the city a lot easier. The list just goes on and on. But today's celebration is not really a celebration of the City of Belton and its public works. The today's celebration is a celebration of veterans and what you guys have done for our country. I never had the honor of serving. By the time I got through with athletics, the Army didn't want to have anything to do with me. I am honored to be a member of a family that contributed greatly to World War II and to the Korean War. With my uncles, I have a nephew that is serving in Afghanistan right now, and you veterans are a special, special breed of Americans. I'm reminded of a bumper sticker I saw a number of years ago that says, if you can read this bumper sticker, thank a teacher. If you're reading it in English, thank a veteran. Thank you very much.